Hey there, my name is Megan and welcome back to my channel.
Hey guys, so I was just about to start editing my video and I was playing back through it and first off, this one would not leave me alone. He kept jumping in my lap and he was laying right up against my chest and right up against my microphone and he was purring so loudly. So all I could hear on the video was this guy purring. So I just wanted to apologize about the purring cat ASMR that y'all are going to receive by watching this video. And Tyler is sorry for being rude and interrupting the video. Okay, back to editing.
Today I'm going to be doing my November wrap-up. So in the month of November, I finished 4 books and I did have 1 DNF. And when I was going back through and like seeing what I read in November, it felt like I read absolutely nothing. But I did read a decent amount of pages. It didn't feel like I read anything. And I feel like I did not have a very good reading month. And I was even considering whether I should even do this wrap-up video just because I found my reading month to be very disappointing. But I decided to do it. So we're going to discuss what I read in November. But before we go ahead and get on into the books, if you are not already subscribed to my channel, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button as well as the little bell icon so you can be notified every time I post new content. I post new bookish videos every Sunday, Wednesday, and sometimes Friday. Also, don't forget to check down in the description box for links to my BuddyRead Discord and my Patreon where you can be entered into winning quarterly book giveaways. As with all of my wrap-ups, I'm gonna go ahead and start with my lowest rated book first and then go up to my highest rated book. I am actually going to be talking about a DNF for the month of November, and I usually don't include my DNFs in my wrap-ups, but I read 85% of this book, so I feel like I can really give a good opinion about it. And the book I DNF'd is The Guinevere Deception by Kirsten White. This is a YA fantasy and it is a Camelot retelling, but in this book we follow Guinevere, and Guinevere is actually not Guinevere. She is a changeling, she is a forest witch, and she takes the place of the real Guinevere who has died. She is sent by Merlin to Camelot to protect Arthur, and I was so excited to read this book because I love Camelot retellings, I love King Arthur retellings, they're some of my favorite retellings, and I personally just did not mesh with this story. I didn't really like the writing style. I found it to be very dry and very boring. I wasn't really that invested in Guinevere as a character. I just didn't find her very interesting. And then we had Mordred, who in this version is Arthur's nephew, which I think in some of the original retellings, it's his son through Morgaine, if I'm remembering correctly. And Mordred was just constantly like being weird and hitting on Guinevere and like just, I don't know, like subtly making passes at her. And I was like, dude, you really need to stop. It's, you know, that's your uncle's wife there, just stop. And I just wasn't all invested in the story, in the magic, and I didn't feel like the stakes were really high. And then there was a gender-bent retelling part of the story that I wasn't really into. And it just didn't interest me enough to keep going, so I decided to DNF at 85%. Can you please lay down? You're being very rude. Can you please lay down? Can you? The next book I read was Priest of Bones by Peter MacLean. This is book one in the War for the Rose Throne series. I know that the first two books are out. This is an adult grimdark fantasy series, and I actually did an entire vlog where I read this book and talked about it. But in this book, we follow a man named Thomas Pitey, and he was conscripted into the army by his queen, sent away to fight this awful, brutal war. And when he gets back, he finds that the city that he lived in has been invaded by these people, all of his business have been taken over, and he basically has to fight to reestablish his authority in his city. And basically, Thomas is a gang lord. He runs a gang. He runs a small section of the city. Other parts of the city are run by different gang lords, and he has interactions with them. And the people that infiltrated this city are actually people from another land who are most likely going to start war with this kingdom. So this book is definitely grimdark. It's very short for a fantasy. The writing is very short, not very descriptive, very abrasive. There are a lot of trigger warnings in this book. I'm not one to usually talk about trigger warnings, but I feel like this book warrants it. There's trigger warnings for drug abuse, alcoholism, violence, child molestation, child rape, violence against women, amongst others. And I felt like some of those things were used just to move the plot along and to show that our main character was a good guy. And I just found like the plot itself was just something that had been done before and wasn't overly unique. The magic in this book was very slight. If you're looking for a fantasy that has a well-developed magic system and magic is like a prominent part of the story, then this is not that. If you like books that are very reminiscent of like The Godfather and movies that have to do with gangs and mobs, then I would recommend this because that is a very, very heavy and influential part of the story and the plot. But all in all, I'm still on the fence if I'm going to continue with the second book of the series. It is short, it is quick to get through, but the character, the world, the plot just didn't grip me enough to make me want to continue right away. So I ended up giving Priest of Bones 3 out of 5 stars. The next book I read was Oathbringer by Brandon Sanderson. This is book 4 in the Stormlight Archives. And this one I felt like took me a really long while to get through. And while I did appreciate a lot of things about this book, especially the ending, I think that the ending was the best part. I felt like this book definitely dragged. And I felt like that the fact that it was longer than all of the other books did not need to be necessary considering the content of the book. I really appreciated the ending though. The ending just set up perfectly for Rhythm of War. We got to learn so much more about the Parshendi, the antagonist, the gods, and their part in this story, and I really appreciated that. But this has definitely been my least favorite out of all of the Stormlight books so far. I still enjoyed it. I still love the world and the characters, and I still gave it 4 out of 5 stars. I just found it to be a little bit dragging. I fed you this morning. I know I did. The next book I read was a novella, and that was Dawn Shard, also by Brandon Sanderson. In this book, we follow Ryson, and Ryson is commissioned by Queen Navani to lead a group of sailors and Radiants to the lost city of Akina because there might be an Oathgate there, and Navani wants to ensure that the enemy does not get control over the Oathgate before they do. So Ryson, who is a paraplegic, and a bunch of Ardents and Lopin and his cousin and a couple other Radiants embark on this mission to this lost city. This novella is about 200 pages long, and I do have a full spoiler and spoiler-free review for this if you're interested in checking it out, but I really liked it. I had a lot of fun with it. I love lost city stories, and I love how much more information we got about the lore and like the origins and the gods that are prevalent in this series. We got to spend more time with the Sleepless and kind of see how they might be involved in the story. And I definitely think that Ryson is going to have a much more prominent role in this series as time goes on. And I'm just really interested to see how the Dawn Shard plays a part in future books. So I feel like Brandon Sanderson was just planting a little seeds for us readers. I didn't rate Dawn Shard because I find it hard to rate a novella because it didn't really have a normal plot progression. So I would suggest reading it before Rhythm of War, but as of right now, I am about 55% into Rhythm of War, and I don't really feel like you need to read it in order to understand Rhythm of War, but I do think it's a good addition to the Cosmere in general. And the last book I finished in November is I Am Malala by Malala Yousafzai. This book I did not start in November. This is a book that the state where I live in has added to our English 1 curriculum. So this is a book that I actually read with my students, and I've never read it before, and I loved it. If you don't know who Malala is, she is a girl who during the mid-2000s was speaking out against the Taliban, advocating for girls' rights to an education. And they targeted her, attempted to assassinate her by shooting her in the head. But Malala survived, and she continues to advocate for girls' rights to an education all over the world. The reason that I like this book so much is I just found it really interesting reading about a completely different culture, both religion-wise, societal-wise, custom-wise, you know, as a Western reader. It was just very interesting. Her writing was just very immersive. She explained everything so well. You know, I didn't really have trouble following along. She talked a lot about the political unrest in her country, the religion, they're Muslim, a lot about the history of Pakistan and how that impacted them today. She talked a lot about her family, and just the family relationship between all of them was just so refreshing to see. It was just a very, very powerful story. It definitely opened my eyes to the struggles that some people face that you might not think about. And it definitely made me grateful to the fact that I live in a place where I do have access to an education. I do have access to books. I do have access to literature and things that sometimes people take for granted. All in all, I gave Malala 5 out of 5 stars. And I recommend that all people, no matter what your age or background, read this book. All right, you guys, so that is it for my November wrap up. Let me know in the comments if you've read any of these books and what you thought about them. Also, let me know some books that you have read in November, and I will see you soon in another video. Goodbye.